Professor Dave here. Let's learn how to write chemical equations.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We know a little bit about chemical reactions, as well as the written equations we can write to depict them. But there are a few different ways we can write these equations. We should be able to write them using chemical formulas, which abbreviate all the elements present in each compound, and sometimes list the phases of each compound. But we should also be able to write these equations using words, because this helps us understand how we might verbally communicate the details of a chemical reaction to someone else. Let's therefore make sure that we can do two things. We must be able to look at a chemical reaction that is written with symbols and translate it into written words. And we must also be able to do this in reverse, by taking a sentence that describes a chemical reaction and making sure we are able to display this transformation using the symbols we know in chemistry. Take this reaction, for example. We have Na solid plus H2O on the reactant side, and then NaOH in the aqueous phase and H2 in the gas phase on the product side. Let's turn this equation into a sentence comprised of normal words. Starting from the left, Na is sodium, and it's a solid, so we might simply say solid sodium metal. Now, what does the sodium react with? We all know H2O is water, and the L means liquid, so let's add reacts with liquid water. Now, the forward arrow separates the reactants from the products, so we need words that indicate that a chemical reaction has occurred. So let's say to produce. And now we list the products. NaOH is sodium hydroxide, and it's in the aqueous phase, so we write aqueous sodium hydroxide. And H2 is hydrogen, which is a gas, so we write hydrogen gas. And now we have completed a sentence that describes in words what the equation describes in symbols. Let's go the other way around. Say we have the following sentence. Solid iron reacts with fluorine gas to produce solid iron 3 fluoride. Let's identify some key words here. Reacts with tells us that iron and fluorine are the reactants, and produce tells us that iron 3 fluoride is the product. So those should be separated by an arrow. Now let's translate the words into chemical symbols and phase symbols. The symbol for iron is Fe, and it's a solid, so let's write Fe with the subscript S in parentheses. Then we put a plus symbol because the iron is reacting with something else. Fluorine has the symbol F, and fluorine gas is F2, which we know from our ability to draw Lewis dot structures. So let's write F2 with the subscript G in parentheses. Then the forward arrow separating the reactants from the products. And lastly, we have iron 3 fluoride. So we know the product has iron and fluorine in it, but in what ratio? If we recall, this Roman numeral 3 is telling us the oxidation state of the iron atom, which will be plus 3. Fluoride ions are minus 1, so we will need 1 iron and 3 fluorides to make a neutral molecule. So we write FeF3 with the subscript S. Lastly, we might want to balance the equation. We can see that we have 2 fluorines on the left and 3 on the right. So let's put a 3 here and a 2 there, so that we have 6 on each side. Now we also have 2 irons on the right, so let's put a 2 here, so that we have 2 irons on the left as well. And that's all there is to it. So we should now be able to write chemical equations either with symbols or with words. Let's check comprehension. Thank you. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.